Hello and welcome to part two of the WSRR policy demonstration. This is policy attachment editing, or how to attach a policy. And it assumes you followed part one, which should have created your policy. We'll start again by logging into the business space interface. And once more, we're on the operations space here. And you'll see in the overview, we have our policy here on the left-hand side. Now, there are two ways of attaching policies to objects. One method is to start from the policy itself, and the other is to start from the object with which you wish to attach it. And that's what we're going to start with today. Now what I've got here is I've got a system that contains the policy from part one, and it also contains all the objects you get if you follow the GEP tutorial in the info center. So you probably want to download yourself if you're just following this demo yourself, or on the other hand, have your own objects which you've got loaded up in your registry. So I'm going to navigate to the SLD for the eligibility service, which you'll see here. Now if we click on the pencil icon to edit, then scroll down, you see attached policies, and we can press add policy. If we start typing in here, up should come my policy, and we can add that. And over here is a little cross. If we click that, it would detach, but obviously we want it to be attached, so we can press finish. And it was as easy as that. The other way, as I say, is to do it from the policy. So if we go back to the overview page, in the watch list here is my mediation policy. We can click on that. And then under action, this is where you get caught out. We're on the document. If you switch to the expression, then under action you get to manage the policy attachments. Now, strictly speaking, you shouldn't be attaching policies that aren't yet approved, but that's going to be covered in a future demo, so we're just leaving them as they are for now. And you can see here the existing one I created before, or we can attach, use the options here to create new ones. We can attach to specific items or using a query. Specific items basically just a search as before, so I could type in the SLD and find it that way. Or with the query, you can actually build up using the XPath editor here, a more complicated query, and that would actually be a dynamic attachment then, so anything new coming in that matched that set of properties would be added. But we're not going to do that here, we're just going to leave it with the one I've already created. And that concludes the second demo. Thank you.